out here in my garage, just picked up this brand new water-powered vehicle. It's kind of fun to drive around in the Nuketown Hills, but you know what I like more than materialistic things? Knowledge! And that knowledge comes in the form of five more things you probably didn't know about Call of Duty Black Ops 3. You guys know the drill by now. If you learned something new in this video, or if you just want to share to show your love for the channel, make sure to click that like button down below. These five things are in no particular order, but let us get started. Number five has to do with our old friend Full Metal Jacket. Did you guys know that if you're using the FMJ attachment and playing the game mode uplink, you'll actually avoid the carrier's armor altogether? This means that if you are using the CUDA, for example, it's going to take 6 shots without FMJ and only 3 shots with FMJ at a close distance, as shown by this test right here. FMJ actually comes in handy in other game modes as well, like Safeguard, doing more damage to the robot because I think that it considers the robot a variant of sorts of the GI unit. This means that FMJ will have a pretty major effect on the Safeguard robot, and this allows you to destroy it quickly. For example, here's the PO6 with FMJ. It takes 6 bursts overall. I am using rapid fire, by the way. And here it is without FMJ, taking nearly double the shots. So if you're playing Safeguard, make sure you have FMJ equipped to your weapon if you plan on attacking the robot. Taking that number 4 spot, this gameplay came from Noisy Bipolar. I'll link his channel down below in the description, but you're actually able to use the death machine not only in campaign, but also in the nightmare mode as well as Dead Ops Arcade. The death machine, of course, was a streak from previous Call of Duty games, and it's just like another minigun except it's not attached to your arm, like Reaper's Scythe. You can get this out of the magic box or mystery box in nightmare modes. You can pick it up as a power-up in Dead Ops Arcade, and you can even use it in first person mode in Dead Ops Arcade as well, which is really cool to see. You can also replenish ammo from ammo crates all around the map in the campaign mode, so this is a really nice weapon to have, especially when going up against hordes of zombies. If you ask me, that's kind of a missed opportunity in the regular zombie mode as well, where you could use that as a power-up, just like we've seen in previous zombie maps, but who cares? It's not there yet. Speaking more about Reaper, we have number 3, which this will actually be a very good tip for those of you that are vigilant on where hive placements are. If you're using Reaper Psychosis ability, Psychosis will actually take out the hives for you. So if you don't want to run into an area, or if you're afraid there's going to be a hive and you're using Engineer and you know what's there, you could send your Psychosis out and those will actually get killed by the hive rather than yourself, and you'll be able to move on to your next enemy. This can be used on multiple different hive pods if they're placed in one area, or if you just want to use it as a distraction, you can definitely do that. But hives will go after your clones and you'll be good. Sometimes one clone can even activate 2, like you see right here, which is interesting. Taking that number 2 spot, we actually have sentry guns. Did you know that sentry guns can actually attack other AI-based score streaks like sentry guns, guardians, they'll attack Cerberus, they'll attack Talons, and you can even get into Cerberus battles with your own Cerberuses. So they can fight each other like a robot war. It's just a constant battle going on. So if there's multiple streaks in one area, your sentry gun will actually do a lot more work than you think. And there's a lot of health behind these things as well. Unfortunately, Guardians versus Guardians don't do anything, but the Cerberus versus Cerberus was pretty cool, and it kind of made me wonder what it would be like to call in a bunch of them at one time and just have a super robot battle. And that may be something you guys will see in the near future right here on the channel, so stay tuned for that. Now, taking that number 1 spot is more or less an Easter egg, which I actually really like, and a lot of you have been sending it to me and told me to add it to this episode, so I'm going to be adding it right here. If you go on the map Stronghold, you can find picture frames all around the map. You'll see Call of Duty Black Ops 2, Call of Duty Black Ops. If you go to the map Fringe, you can see Call of Duty World at War, Call of Duty Black Ops in the background as a poster. And if you go to other maps, including Fringe right here, on the downstairs level, you'll find a picture frame on the desk. This picture is actually another multiplayer map in the game, and this is Hunted, which is absolutely awesome to see. It's great to find these little Easter eggs all around, and Hunted is in a lot of different maps, so you can see this picture everywhere. But paying attention is pretty cool. There's a lot more little Easter eggs that we could talk about in future episodes, but let me know what you guys think down below in the comments section. Did any of these tips help you out today? What'd you think about the FMJ tip? Are you going to be using that in a future gameplay that you do? Let me know your thoughts down below in the comment section. Once again, if you enjoyed this video, make sure to click that like button down below, and do not forget to subscribe for more awesome videos each and every day. Until next time, everybody, I am out. Peace.